Welcome to Chilango's cooking channel. Today, the question, enchiladas rojas or enchiladas verdes? This is a millenary question, has divided people in Mexico. I've seen families tear apart of this reason. I've seen people going really, really angry on each other because it's really hard. In my opinion, I'm not gonna tell you my opinion, but leave me a comment. Maybe I'll let you know which one is my favorite. However, I am a very middle ground person. So I would say often I like to make rojas and verdes and then just leave it for the people to fight about it. Anyway, today we're gonna make salsa verde and we're gonna make enchiladas verdes. Because if we already made rojas, we need to be fair and square. And this is different flavor, same steps. We're gonna retake many of the things we already saw in salsa roja version. We're also gonna use the sweet potato. We're also gonna use chicken. I must add, you can use beef, you can use pork, you can play around, it's up to you. Now, one important thing, I'm gonna also make a little cut on it and make only salsa verde because it's so simple, it's so fast, and when you don't cook it and you just leave it raw, it's also a delicious salsa, but it only lasts for one day. I wouldn't use it the next day. So that's just a little extra from this recipe. You're gonna have fresh salsa verde, and we're gonna make enchiladas. So let's get to it. So we're gonna need sweet potato, and for more details, I'll show you how to make also a sweet potato. We have also some chicken already cooked, and then we have the tortillas from our sponsor, Don Tortilla. And we are also gonna have cream cheese this time, just to twist a little bit. You can use traditionally sour cream. We have also the vegan versions, also for the topping cheese. Then we have queso fresco, and we also have regular shredded cheese. I'm using Gouda. You could use manchego if it's available. Just make sure it's a fat cheese that's gonna gratinate properly. And we have here also the queso fresco that I mentioned. You could also use feta if you don't find the queso fresco. Here we have cilantro, we have garlic, we have the silver onions, we also have the yellow onions. I think for the salsa you can use either, you can use both. We have jalapenos here. You can use also chile de árbol or serrano, but make sure it's fresh. And finally, we have the tomatillos. And I wanted to take a little minute to talk about the tomatillos. Sometimes they are pretty expensive, and especially if you don't get them fresh, you end up buying small cans and they are very, very pricey. Making these videos, I realized that if you want to be a little more economic, you can buy a big can and you can divide it in small tupperwares and you can freeze it. And it's gonna be perfectly fine the next time you use your tomatillos. I think it's a silly thing, but I'm pretty sure I was worth mentioning because I was working so many years in restaurant business and I never thought about it until I started cooking at home these recipes, and then I realized. So I hope it saves you a few euros. So let's begin with the salsa verde. I'm adding here the tomatillos and a little bit of the water that comes with the canned tomatillos. If you would be using fresh tomatillos, just add a little bit of water, but not too much, in order to keep the salsa nice and thick. Then I'm adding onions, the green chilies, and also coriander. And as well, a little bit of garlic. Be very careful with the garlic, you don't want to overpower the rest of the flavors. And then, all you're gonna do is simply add a little bit of salt, and that easy, and that's it. Blend them all, and there you go, salsa verde. So here we have the portion that I'm gonna separate for salsa. Now I'm gonna try it. This one is like raw salsa verde, but the tomatillos were from the can, but it's pretty good. And there's a lot of flavor in it. You could boil the tomatillos and then do the whole process, just following the same steps to get the salsa verde and to make the enchiladas. But you can also do it completely raw. It's really good, and basically the only reason why I'm not doing it right now is because here in Finland, where I'm living, it's very hard. But if you live somewhere where you have raw tomatillos, I highly recommend it. It's also really good, two different profiles. And actually there are some people, like my cousin, who likes to use half of them cooked and blended, and the other half raw, and then just chopped. It makes a nice and amazing chunky salsa verde.
So let's go back to making the enchiladas. I'm gonna boil the salsa verde to simmer all the flavors and to just simply make another version of salsa verde, which will be cocida or cooked salsa verde. That's gonna last much longer than the raw version if you're gonna keep it in the fridge. And then we're gonna cook now the sweet potato, just like we did in the enchiladas rojas. So you're gonna wash the sweet potato, make a few incisions with a knife very carefully, and then we're gonna toast it into the oven, which is preheated at 400 degrees Fahrenheit, which is about 200 Celsius. And we're gonna let it cook for 45 minutes to 1 hour until it's nice and soft. And we will know it's cooked because once we start skinning it off, the skin will come easily, like you can see with this one. You make no effort and you know that it's perfectly cooked. And this is delicious. It's really, really simple. And I could almost say that sweet potato enchiladas is something you really definitely should try. Let's move on with the chicken. So all we gotta do is boil the chicken. You can also grill it, and as I said, you can use other meat. In this case, I'm simply using the chicken with a little bit of salt and let it boil until it's nice and tender. And then all you gotta do is shred it all, so then we can move forward to assemble our enchiladas. Oh, and let's not forget about the rice. So, long grain rice, and we're gonna use 2 portions of water for 1 portion of rice, and I'm gonna add a few veggies, and then a little bit of salt, and that's it. We let the rice cook in the rice cooker, and let's move on with the other things. We're gonna fry the tortillas just to soften them, so it has to be a very quick fry in a very hot oil. If you have a deep fryer, you can just simply put them down for a few seconds and then bring them up. This is gonna add much more flavor to the corn tortilla, and it's gonna let us fold those tortillas much easily once we make our enchiladas. You can also warm up the tortillas on a comal or a pan and then make them a little bit less fat. But these are delicious, and let's not think much about the calories when we're doing these kind of dishes.
So like in the other video, 2 ways to assemble enchiladas. The kind of like restaurant, one meal, one person system. And then now we're gonna make the all getting together, simple, easy. The one that you can actually prepare beforehand. Just leave it in the fridge, and then when your guests come, you just put the oven 200 Celsius, 392 Fahrenheit, preheat it, boom. Enchiladas to the oven, gratinated, nice and ready to boom, jump in and eat. So we start by folding the enchiladas, and this time I'm also gonna put a few sweet potatoes mixed into the equation. However, obviously, if you would be making for meat eaters and vegans, you make sure they are not in the same container. But this time, just making a little example, because this is all for me today. We don't have guests in the house again. No cleaning kitchen, at least till tomorrow.
So all you gotta do is fold the tortillas, and then once you get them all ready, go ahead and cover them with a generous portion of the salsa. I think that you can use plenty of salsa, and especially for this version, just go ahead and cover them all. Make sure that they are all properly covered and almost to the point where they are swimming in salsa. Be careful how spicy you do it, because this kind of dish has a lot of salsa. So just go easy on the chili. And now we top it up with the cheese we're gonna use for gratinating. We preheat the oven 400 Fahrenheit, 200 Celsius, and that's it. And now let's move on for the portion for one person.
The rice is gonna help a lot for a presentation. And then I'm just gonna put aside our beans. And now we will gently put the sweet potato. Oh, sorry.
So we're gonna cover the enchiladas with the hot salsa verde. And when I mean hot, I mean as in it's warm, because this is the kind of dish that everything is just put in together and the right temperatures. So you get the rice, which is warm, the beans as well. the tortillas and the fillings, and the salsa. Everything has to be ready and warm to assemble the dish really quickly. And then you're gonna top it up with cheese. In this case, these ones are vegan, so I'm using vegan feta cheese. And then I'm gonna also use onions and vegan sour cream. But as I said, obviously if you're using or you're making meat version, you would be using regular queso fresco or feta cheese and then the onions. And this time I remembered to use a piping bag in order to decorate the cream in a much nicer way. And I think you should do the same because it's a very small detail, but it looks much better than spooning it with two spoons. Or if you just spread it on the plate. Sometimes the cream that we use in Mexico is much thinner, so they also make some sort of decorations between the cream and the salsa. And now that the ones that we put in the oven are ready, and as you can see, it's already getting nice and crusty. So this is just perfect to put a little bit of cheese as well, queso fresco in this case. These ones have also meat, so we're gonna just put that queso fresco, and then I'm gonna add also some onions. I think some people also like to put the onions before going to the oven. That's also pretty valid, so they're gonna be a little bit less strong and caramelize a little bit from the cooking, and then a lot of cream because I love cream. Actually, I didn't used to use so much cream in Mexican food when I was living in Mexico, but I think that after living abroad, I became a fan of sour cream in Mexican food. I admit it. And here we have our dishes ready and super good looking ones. I really hope you make this recipe and I really wish it goes super good and that you enjoy it. Please leave us a comment.
There it is. Super fast, super simple. And you have the two versions. And this time I think it was nicer than instead of spooning the cream, I used this little piping bag. I don't know why I didn't thought about it last time, because definitely gives you a better result. And like always, just gonna give it a little try, this time by myself. Didn't have guests two times. And here comes the chicken one. Always making sure we have a little bit of, in this case it's cheese cream, but you can use cream, just regular sour cream. Salsa, and there's all the goodies there. Nam! And let's give it a try to the sweet potato. I'll try to show you all the colors here. There we go. Nice and steamy. And bon appetit. There's some real interesting thing I just want to say before we close it up. Even if you're meat eaters, and I'm not trying to sell any vegan agenda here, but try the sweet potato. We were just discussing yesterday with the guests, there's something special about sweet potato enchilada. The sweet potato brings also something very interesting. It's like a little mellow sweet flavor. It's just, you should try it. I highly recommend it. Anyhow, what I always recommend you is like the video, subscribe to the channel, share the recipes, cook it at home, make a comment, leave a comment, and like always, I will be very happy to see you next time. Bye.